अस्सलाम वालेकुम, दिस इज़ राबिया मसूदी एंड टुडे आई एम हियर विद द वेरी फर्स्ट लेसन ऑफ द टेक्स्ट बुक ऑफ सेकेंड ईयर एंड टुडेज टॉपिक इज़ द डाइंग सन एंड इन दिस वीडियो आई विल ट्राई टू एक्सप्लेन द टेक्स्ट एंड आई विल ऑल्सो ट्राई टू गिव द लिटिल बिट ट्रांसलेशन ऑफ द मेन आइडियाज फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स हु फाइंड इट हार्ड टू ट्रांसलेट देमसेल्व्स. सो लेट्स हैव अ लुक ऑन द टेक्स्ट. A few stars are known which are hardly bigger than the earth, but most of them are so large that thousands of earths could be packed inside each and leave room here and there. We find an immense place large enough to contain millions and millions of earths, and the total number of stars in the universe is probably something like the total number of grains of sand on all the seashores of the world. Such is the littleness of our home in space when measured up against the total substance of the universe. So basically this paragraph focuses on two things: the littleness of Earth and the hugeness of the universe, of the stars. The writer wants to say that we humans feel that Earth is very large. It is so large that we hardly can travel it. But in reality, the Earth is very little as compared to the stars. Because if we want to pack one Earth into one star, there will be a lot of room left for thousands of Earths to pack in. वो ये कहता है कि अगर आप एक ज़मीन को उठा के एक सितारे में रखेंगे तो आपको लगेगा कि आप हज़ारों ज़मीनें उठा के उस सितारे में पैक कर सकते हैं. इतनी छोटी है ज़मीन सितारों के मुकाबले में. On the other hand, he compares the number of stars with the number of grains on the seashore of all the world. वो कहते हैं कि इतनी ज़्यादा सितारे हैं फिज़ा में कि अगर आप समुंदर के किनारे पे जो पड़ी हुई रेत है उसके ज़र्रात को गिनें तो ये भी उतने ही होंगे जैसे कि वो ज़र्रात हैं. So little our earth is if we compare it with the universe or with even one star. So we feel that we are living on the planet which is greatest, which is so bigger, because we believe in the greatness of humanity, the greatness of human beings. So we should take a lesson that actually there are things which we have not seen and they are greater than us. So we should be humble and we should see the universe to expand our vision and our knowledge. These millions of stars are wandering about in space. A few form groups with journey in company, but most of them travel alone. There are two kind of stars. There are ones who live alone, like some of the people out there. And there are some stars, most of the stars which live in company, in groups, in communities. And they travel through a universe so immense that it is very, very rare event indeed for one star to come anywhere near to another. So it never happens that they just come together and they collapse or they break each other by coming together. For most part, each star makes its voyage in complete loneliness. Mostly they travel alone. If we make a scale model, कैसा नमूना तैयार करें जहाँ पर हम सितारों को draw करें या रखें और ships को रखें, तो हमें लगेगा, हमें पता चलेगा कि average there will be million miles between one star and another. So there is no chance that one star may come near another. So we can have an idea that how much space stars have between each other. Such is the vastness of universe. इस paragraph में writer ये हमें बताना चाहता है कि हमारी जो universe है वो इतनी ज़्यादा बड़ी है, इतनी ज़्यादा उसकी greatness है. It is so great, it is so immense that such a big star, so many big stars who can pack thousands of Earths, even they cannot come closer. Because they have so much space between them. So this was the lesson for today. I tried to cover two paragraphs because I want to give you quality, not quantity. So for more videos like this, for more lectures, please like this video and subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Have a nice day.